In this illustration, we'll discuss about analysis of a block hitting on a wall. Here the figure shows a system held at rest and the masses of block A and B are 2 kg and 0.5 kg. Here it is saying if the system is released, we are going to find with what speed block A will hit the wall. Now, in this situation, to find out the speed, as we already studied, that we can use the work energy theorem. So, here if we redraw the picture, when block A will hit the wall, say it is hitting with the speed V1, the string of 1 meter length will be vertical and the other string would be in this shape where the block B is hanging. In this situation, as this length is 2 meter, this length will be root 5 meter and you can see block B would be displaced up by a height h, which can be written as earlier this 1 meter, now this root 5 meter, this root 5 minus 1 meter. Now in this situation, we can easily apply the work energy theorem in initial and final state if B is moving up with the speed V. And here if this angle is theta, then here you can see if this angle is theta in this situation, the speed with which the block A would be moving along the length of a string will be V1 sine theta. So, constraint relation we can write, the velocity of block B is equals to V1 multiplied by sine theta, and here the value of sine theta will be 2 by root 5. Now, in this situation, we can write using work energy theorem. We can write initial kinetic energy of the blocks was 0 as these were released from rest. And when these are falling, block A is displaced down by 1 meter. So, here the work done by gravity on it is mgh. This is mass of A, g. The depth by which A has fallen is 1 meter. Minus work done by gravity on block B, it is in opposite direction, so work done by gravity is negative. This mass of block B, G, height would be root 5 minus 1 meter. And this should be equals to the final kinetic energy of the system. For block A, we can write it as half MAV1 square plus for block B, it is half MBV square. We substitute the values, mass of block A is 2 kg and G is 10, so this will be 20 minus mass of block B is 0.5, G is 10, so this will be 5 root 5 plus 5 is equals to, here mass of block A is 2, so this 2 gets cancelled out, this will be V1 square plus mass of block B is 0.5. So, this will be 1 by 4 and V we can substitute as V1 multiplied by 2 by 5. So, this V1 square multiplied by 4 by 5. So, here this 4 gets cancelled out. And on left hand side, this will be 25 minus 5 root 5. And on right hand side, it is V1 square multiplied by 1 plus 1 by 5, which is 6 by 5. So, this will give us the speed of block A, V1, with which the block A will hit the wall. This is under the root 25 minus 5 root 5 divided by 6 multiplied by 5. I am leaving it as an exercise for you to solve. The result numerical value of this speed finally obtained will be 3.4 meters per second. That is the final result of this problem.